Generally, glands are of two types, exocrine glands and endocrine glands. Exocrine glands, they are having the blood vessels with the help, they are having the ducts, with the help of the ducts, they can pour their secretions into the target organ. But in the case of endocrine glands, they don't have any vessels or ducts. They can secrete the hormones. These hormones goes into the blood. Blood is the river of life. Through the blood, it goes into the target organ. Target organ here is the affected organ. Generally, the endocrine glands are so many types. The first and foremost gland is the pituitary gland, thyroid gland, adrenal gland, as well as the parathyroid gland, as well as the glands of the ovary and the testes. These are the important thymus gland. These are the important glands. Now you can see the pituitary. Pituitary gland is rightly called as the master gland of the endocrine system, or the bandman of the endocrine orchestra, or the chief chef of the endocrine system. Here you can see the pituitary gland. Pituitary gland is present in the brain region near to the hypophysis. It attaches to the hypophysis by means of a stalk-like structure called the infundibulum. Generally, the pituitary gland is also called as the hypophysis. It attaches to the hypothalamus by means of a stalk-like structure called infundibulum. The hypophysis or pituitary gland, it generally measures about 0.5 grams. That means half gram, and it measures about 1.3 in diameter. The pituitary gland is responsible for the growth, development, reproduction, and metabolism of the animal. That's why it is called as the master gland of the endocrine system. And hence it is called as the master gland of the endocrine system. Generally, the pituitary gland has three parts. One is the anterior pituitary, posterior pituitary, and middle pituitary, that is middle lobe. Generally, it has three parts. One is the anterior pituitary, middle pituitary, as well as the posterior pituitary. Nowadays, the people call the anterior as well as the middle pituitary as the anterior lobe. Now, you can see the general organization of pituitary. Below the hypothalamus, the pituitary gland is present. It is present 0.5 grams. It attaches to the hypothalamus by means of a stalk-like structure called infundibulum. When you see the structure of pituitary, pituitary shows two parts, one the anterior part and posterior part. The anterior lobe shows the secretory part, whereas the posterior lobe shows the neural part. Here, you can see the pituitary gland hormones. The anterior pituitary, posterior pituitary, and attaches to the hypothalamus by means of a stalk-like structure called infundibulum. Here, the anterior pituitary will release so many hormones. You can see the growth hormone. Growth hormone has the effect on bone, muscles, and organs. That is, it can affect the bones, muscles, and organs. That is why it is called the affected organ or target organ. Whereas the prolactin is the luteotropic hormone. It has the effect on the breasts. Whereas the luteinizing hormone has the effect on the ovaries, produces estrogen and progesterone. Here, the follicle stimulating hormone, it also affect on ovaries as well as in the testes, as well as you can see the adrenocorticotropic hormone. It can affect the adrenal cortex and it releases the steroid hormones. Thyroid stimulating hormone, this hormone released from the anterior pituitary, This anterior pituitary release the thyroid stimulating hormone. This thyroid stimulating hormone can activate or stimulate the thyroid gland, which is present on the neck region. It can affect the thyroid gland and it produces the thyroid hormones. And posterior pituitary will release two types of principal hormones. One is the vasopressin and oxytocin. Vasopressin is also called as antidiuretic hormone. Oxytocin, this vasopressin is a direct effect on kidneys. The target organ will be the kidney. Next, the oxytocin. Oxytocin is also called as birth-giving hormone because during the labor, during the delivery, it can produce the labor pains and responsible for the delivery of the baby and contraction of the uterus. That's why it is called as the birth-giving hormone. It also affect on the breast. After delivery, it can initiate the ejection of milk from the breast. That's why it is called as a milk ejecting hormone as well as birth giving hormone. Now you can see the general organization of different hormones. Here I will give the mnemonics. GHMC, fry leg and thigh parts of velvet owl. You can see GHMC means the Greater Hyderabad Municipal Corporation, fry leg and thigh parts of velvet owl. That is the saying. With the help of this saying, you can draw different hormones. GH means growth hormone or somatotropin. M means melanocyte stimulating hormone. C means corticotropic hormone or adrenocorticotropic hormone. FSH means here, the fry means FSH. FSH means follicle stimulating hormone. The L means luteinizing hormone. Leg means here the luteinizing hormone. Thigh means here the thyroid stimulating hormone. Whereas the P means, parts means prolactin. And the posterior lobe of the pituitary will release two hormones. You can see that is vasopressin and oxytocin. V means vasopressin. Vasopressin is also called as ADH, antidiuretic hormone. The O means here oxytocin. Oxytocin is also called as birth-giving hormone. Now you can see the different types of hormones produced by the anterior pituitary as well as the posterior pituitary. You can see one by one. First of all, you can see the anterior pituitary. Anterior pituitary will release so many hormones. You can see the first and foremost hormone is the growth hormone. Growth hormone is also called as somatotropin. It can regulate the growth in human beings. It can initiate the protein synthesis. It can stimulate the elongation of bones and growth of muscles and organs. Hyper secretion, that means excessive secretion or over secretion, leads to gigantism and another disorder called acromegaly. Hyposecretion or under secretion will lead to dwarfism. In the case of the gigantism, the people appears to be 7 to 8 feet in height, abnormal growth in long bones. That's why they appears to be very tall. Acromegaly is nothing but a chimpanzee-like structure, what you called as acromegaly. Dwarfism is caused due to the deficiency of this hormone during embryonic development or in a child stage. It leads to dwarfism. The people appears to be 3 to 4 feet in length or in height. Generally, this is the growth hormone. Now you can see the different hormones. One is thyroid stimulating hormone. It can stimulate the thyroid gland and secretes thyroid hormone. this thyroid hormone is meant for BMR. BMR means basal metabolic rate. That means it can initiate the metabolism in animals. Adrenocorticotropic hormone, it can stimulate the cortex of adrenal gland and produces steroid hormones. Next one is follicle stimulating hormone. It can stimulate the seminiferous tubules in the testes in males and produces sperms. The sperm synthesis is called spermiogenesis. And in females, the follicle stimulating hormone will lead to the ovarian follicle development. Another hormone, luteinizing hormone, it induces leading cells of testes and corpus luteum in females. The luteinizing hormone produces luteinizing hormone will initiate the leading cells and produces testosterone in corpus luteum in female, leads to the ovulation, and it also produces the female hormone called progesterone and estrogen. Prolactin, it can stimulate the growth of the breast in females during lactation. During after delivery, there will be a lactation. This is done by the prolactin. It is also called luteotropic hormone and maintain the corpus luteum. Melanocyte stimulating hormone, it can control the dispersal of melanophores in vertebrates. The activity of melanocytes depends on the sunlight. If the animal is exposed to more sunlight, the melanocytes will be expressed in more and more melanin. That means dark pigment will be produced. In the Scandinavian countries, the sunlight is very, very less. That's why they appears to be very, very fair in nature. No melanin is seen. The hyperactivity leads to hyperpigmentation. Hormones of posterior pituitary. Posterior pituitary will produce vasopressin. It can stimulate the uriniferous tubules in kidney and meant for absorption of water. Its deficiency leads to diabetes insipidus. It is free from sugar. The diabetes insipidus is characterized by excessive thirst, that is polydipsia, and excessive urine formation, that is polyuria. It also leads to dehydration. Generally, whenever the people affected with diabetes insipidus, they are always present in bathroom, and they can release nearly 40 liters of urine per day. This is one of the disorder. This can be corrected by giving the vasopressin or ADH hormones to them. Now you can see the oxytocin. It initiates the ejection of milk from mammary glands, that is in breast, and it also causes contraction of uterus during parturition, that is labor during birth giving process. It can causes libido in humans. Libido is nothing but a sexual urge in humans. It can maintain maternal behavior in humans. This is the gist about the pituitary gland. Thank you one and all. And one more thing here is the deficiency of the or atrophy or degeneration of anterior part of the pituitary leads to the disorder called Simon's disease. The skin of the face becomes dry and wrinkled and shows the premature aging. This is the disorders of the pituitary gland. Thank you one and all for watching this video. We will go another topic also in near future. Thank you one and all.